Hey, it's Rich, the Louisiana Hobby Guy. I'm sorry about all the background noise right now, but I am running some tests on the longer E1, I think it is, 30-watt laser. So I don't want to interrupt that, but I do want to get this video out. Today we're going to be talking about how to connect to the LaserMATIC 10 in AP mode directly to its Wi-Fi from your browser. So let's get started. So the first thing that we're going to do is start a web browser. And I am using Google Chrome. So what I'm going to do is add a shortcut here, and I'm going to name this LaserMATIC 10. And then in the URL here, I'm going to paste in the IP address. And that IP address is 192.168.4.1. And I'm going to say done. But I'm going to come back in here real quickly and edit it. And I'm going to take out the S on HTTP right here and say done. So now I've got my shortcut added in my browser. Let's jump into Lightburn and let's take a look and see what it says here. You can see right here, it shows you the IP address of the LaserMATIC 10. So I'm going to close Lightburn now that we've verified it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to unplug the network cable from the LaserMATIC, and you heard it disconnect. Now at this point, I'm going to come to my Wi-Fi connections over here. I'm going to turn on my Wi-Fi, and there is the LaserMATIC 10. So we're going to click on that. I'm going to click on connect. And now you can see it says that there is no internet, but it is connected. So we are connected to the LaserMATIC. Now I can follow my shortcut here for the LaserMATIC 10. And you'll see that it is connecting. So we are now connected to the laser. And I'm going to bring up Lightburn again, even though I have the USB unplugged. And I'm only doing this so I can use the camera feature. I'm going to go to the camera control. And you can see there is the workbed of the LaserMATIC. Hopefully I can get rid of this. And I'll just bring this way down here so it's not really in the way. So you can see that we are now connected. We're not connected in Lightburn, we're connected on this web UI. I will change the speed at which the laser moves over here to 3000. And this is gonna disappear when I click the buttons, but let me change the move distance to 200. So I will click up and this screen will disappear, but I'll bring it right back. And there you can see that it's moving. I'll click up again. And you see that we now have full control over the laser. Now, not only do we have full control, but we can also upload files. And a lot of people are saying, yeah, but where do I get these NC files from? Well, if we come back to Lightburn and bring Lightburn back up onto the screen here. So now what we can do is we can design our file in Lightburn, use our art library, whatever it is that we need to do. And then on the laser tab, instead of hitting start, what we're gonna do is we're gonna click save G-code. So I'll click save G-code. And we're going to get off the network. We're going to come over here onto my D drive. And we're just going to call this test and hit save. And now we're done with Lightburn. We've done all of our designing. We're not going to actually use it. We're just going to use it to transfer the file. So now in here, in the web UI, you'll see you've got everything in here. You've got your console. Everything that you need is in here. You can send commands to the console. You can see that it's communicating. And what we're going to do is we're going to come up here to the drop-down menu, click on SD file, click on this upload button right here. We're going to go to my D drive where I saved it, and we're going to grab this test and say open. And you'll see now that test GC has shown up here in the files that are on this laser. So now all I have to do is come down here and hit frame, and you'll see this message comes up. Click the send button to view the frame. I'm going to click send, and you can hear it in the background, but you can't see it. But there you see that the laser is now framing the job exactly where I have it placed here on in absolute coordinates on the workbed. So at this point, once the framing finishes, we can now close this. All we have to do is click the start button here, and that will start the job. And now the framing is finished. You see it says idle. I can hit start. I'm not going to start this job right now, but I just wanted to show you how to upload files to the SD card. Now, if we come back here, we can go also to settings, and in here are all of your G-code settings, just like you have in the console. The only difference is that this tells you what the setting is used for. So as an example, a lot of you are familiar with the $110 and $111, which is the maximum speed that the laser can travel at. And you really don't want to change any of these settings, but you can here in this program. It is actually better than the Lightburn console. But be careful if you're going to change those settings. And that really is about it as far as this is concerned. This is your speed, and this is the move. So this would be how fast the laser moves around when you click any of these arrows, and this will be how far it moves. So right now we have it set at 1500 millimeters per minute, and 50 millimeters is the distance each time we click one of these arrows. And that really is about everything that you need to know. All right, let's talk about STA mode for a moment. So there are two types of modes that you can connect. There's AP mode, where you connect directly to the LaserMATIC, and then there's ST mode, or STA mode, where you connect to your home network. Now, I'm gonna show you how to connect to your home network, but I'm not going to be able to do it with the LaserMATIC 10 because it's just too far away from the Wi-Fi router to be able to get the IP address assigned to it from the router. So it's too far away. It's like 25 or 30 feet away, and it needs to be closer, and it would be a big project to move it in closer so I can get that IP address. Besides, that's not where I'm going to use it. So maybe in the future I'll get like a repeater or something and put it in the shop next door, but right now I use wired connections over there, so I'm not going to be able to actually connect, but I can show you how to connect. So let me show you in the other shop real quickly. Okay, so now that we've connected in AP mode, let's try and connect a different way. Let's see if we can get the laser onto the home network. So let's go to the MKS laser tools on the dashboard, double click that. Okay, so we've got MKS laser tools up. Let's click on this one right here, Wi-Fi configuration tool. And in here, we're looking for the laser, COM13. Let's try and connect. And it is connected because you see that big red disconnect button. So I'm going to type in here the network, and then I'm going to put in the password, and I'm going to click connect Wi-Fi. And you see that it just rebooted. So let's get the IP address, and it is telling us that it's 192.168.4.1. That's not what we want. We already know that it's broadcasting that. So we're going to just try it again, the connect Wi-Fi button, and this doesn't always work. So we may not always be able to get onto your home network, but this is how you would get onto your home network. So my home network is probably a bit too far away. I'm going to say that the Wi-Fi router is probably, 35 feet away. So it is not reading it. But this is how you would connect to your home network. So all you have to do is put in your username, your password. It has to be a 2.4 gigahertz network. And then you just click on here that says connect Wi-Fi. If the Wi-Fi is within range, it will connect to your home network on the 2.4 gigahertz network. Mine will not because it's just too far away. And there you go. That's about it. So very easy, very simple setup. Now, if you're obviously not going to have MKS laser tools on your dashboard, your dashboard. Why do I keep saying that? On your desktop. But it is included on the USB thumb drive that came with your LaserMATIC. So you would just browse to that installation file. It's called NKS Laser Tools Setup. Double click that, install the program, then it will be on your desktop and you can start it. So it's very simple. You start the network, you click connect Wi-Fi, you go ahead and put your COM port in. It's gonna see the COM port right away. Click connect, put in your username and password, and then click connect Wi-Fi. And depending on the IP address that you get, if you get that 192.168.4.1, that means that your Wi-Fi network is out of range and it's not finding it. So you have two options there. You can get a range extender and put it in the room where the LaserMATIC is, and then you'll be able to connect through the range extender, or you can move it closer to your router. In my case, it's too far away. It's also behind a wall. There are also there's also 3/4-inch sheetrock on both sides of the wall, and there's metal beams in between. So there's lots of reasons why that Wi-Fi signal is not getting through to the next shop next door. I do get a weak signal there, but not enough to connect to the LaserMATIC. So that's it. You can connect perfectly fine in AP mode if your computer is close enough. I found that it's about 17 or 18 feet seems to be the distance. And if you disable the switches in the front where you can open the door, you might be able to get another couple feet out of it. But that's about as far as I could get with the Wi-Fi connection with my laptop. So all said and done, easy process, easy to do. Hope you enjoyed the video today. And I didn't take too long. I know sometimes I go off on a tangent, but that's who I am. So I hope you enjoyed the video today as much as I enjoyed making it for you. And as always, I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.